apparently this is a very nice laptop. That's the word on the street. It's the new Surface Laptop 2. Look at it. It's stealth mode. It's low profile. I've heard good things about the keyboard as well, which is, you know, it's sort of become the differentiating factor. How good can the keyboard be when you have this crazy thin laptop? Of course, recently I looked at the new MacBook Air. The one that I've got in front of me is an 8th gen Intel Core i5 with 256 of storage, 8 gigabytes of RAM. Of course, you could spec this out differently. Willie, how much is this one in USD? Starts at $1,000. This one is $1,300. How high can you take it, Willie? $2,700. Okay, so they're not messing around because the streets are talking and they're talking about Surface Laptop 2. Dun, 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 dun. Ooh. Ah, look at that. Slick package, I must say. They might know how to do hardware. Well, you know I like the blacked out design. It's light. Will, what's the weight on that? I'm gonna get, wait, let me guess. 3.2 pounds. Is that 2.7? 2.76. You know what that means? It is almost the exact same weight as the new MacBook Air. It's 2.75. We have USB, Thunderbolt. There's a headphone jack as well. It's some kind of a proprietary connector. I'm assuming it's like the other Surface products. Wow, the power brick is tiny. So you would just give it like that. It's magnetic. And that's a nice touch as well. On the power adapter, they give you the USB. How big is the screen, Will? 13.5. It's a little bigger than the MacBook Air as well. Ooh, some hardware. Would you look at that? This is soft. Woo! Will, just come for a quick touch. Quick touch. Come on, please. Show the people. Give them a quick one. Exactly. There it is. That's the noise you would make. Just look at Jack and do that. You got a pretty big trackpad here. There's a little bit of flex in the middle here. The keys themselves definitely have more travel than the MacBook series, in my estimation. That's a real, look at that. Here's a look at the display. Seems pretty high resolution. Will, can we get a pixel count, please? 2256 by 1504. Kind of an unusual resolution. It's a little bit lower resolution than the new MacBook Air. Also, from a brightness perspective, I mean, this is a very bright environment, but I kind of wish it had a little more jump to it. There's a slightly brighter background. I would say it's sufficient. It's not the brightest display I've ever seen. A little bit of typing here on the keyboard, and I'm a fan of it. It's super responsive and it just has that little bit more travel. I will say though, because of that flex in the deck, it kind of feels a little bit less quality maybe than the MacBook Air, since I think that's what a lot of people who are gonna buy this thing might compare it to. That said, you get a little bonus as well for this Alcantara feel, this material. That is a very comfortable place to be. It's like the softest keyboard deck I've ever experienced. So here it is, it's the new MacBook
okay.
Air. Pick your RAM as well, 8 or 16 gigabytes. It's not gonna be the cheapest laptop in the world.
Display looks good, audio's good. It's firing from under the keyboard.
It's gonna get the job done. I mean, you still have the headphone jack, so you could use that too. The keyboard is also backlit. Let's see if I can boost it up here. Yes, the keys are illuminated. Okay, so who is this thing for? Who's going to be interested in it? I think a lot of people actually. You want a thin and light, you want something portable, you like the stealth look. If you're a user who wants something thin and light, under 3 pounds, but you want to step up to say the i7 and spec this thing out, it does go all the way up to like $2,700. This is one of the few places you can do that in a sub 3 pound package that's finished quite like this one. Now, if you are considering the Apple side of things, then this thing goes direct head to head with that brand new MacBook Air. And in that case, I think this one offers up a little bit more configurability with the processor options. But the MacBook Air is kind of tough to touch from a fit and finish standpoint. The thing just feels super solid. Not that this one doesn't, but Apple does a really good job of giving you a solid unibody construction. Obviously, this can do something that you can't do
on a MacBook Air, you can reach up and touch the screen. After all, this is a Surface product still. So there you have it. It is the new Surface Laptop 2. I think we have a pretty nice package here and a truly valid competitor to the MacBook Air. You tell me in the comments, if you had to choose, would it be the Surface Book 2 or the new MacBook Air?